Today on Let's Talk Crimes, Frank is going to talk to us about kickback and what are some of the differences between kickback and actual healthcare fraud. So Frank, tell us about kickback.
Before I do that, welcome to Let's Talk Crimes. I hope that everybody had a great Thanksgiving holiday with their families and friends. And you too, Mr. Narrator, you get away with murder in this program. Everybody hears your voice and nobody gets to know you.
Thank you.
Kickback. I like to start with plain English. Kickback means, in legal language, means that in the healthcare business specifically, healthcare provider cannot receive anything of value in exchange for business. And a general public like you and I cannot give business to a healthcare provider in exchange for something of value. That's how simple it is. The statute is, I like to give you the statute number. I think it's always good to know the exact statute so you can review it yourself. It's 42 U.S.C. 1320, and I believe it's subsection B. You can look it up. The title of the statute is illegal remuneration. Remuneration is anything of value. Just to give you an example, if you're an optometrist, you have a patient before you, and he needs to see an oncologist. You cannot refer, if you're a provider, you cannot refer that patient to an oncologist and expect the oncologist to give you something of value back, period. That's what it means.
And for some of the viewers that probably saw the healthcare fraud episode, you know, what's the difference between healthcare fraud and kickback?
The kickback statute falls under the healthcare fraud. Statute one led to the other. The difference is, one of them is the exposure of sentences. If you were to be found guilty under healthcare fraud, you can get up to 20 years in state prison. Under the kickback statute, if you're found guilty, you could receive a sentence of up to 10 years.
And, you know, it doesn't really seem too bad when you describe the crime, because I know in probably other businesses, you know, it sounds like something that's legal. So why is it illegal in the medical business?
That's a great question and something great to bring up. Attorneys like myself that represent these always struggle with clients not understanding that it's a crime. It's a crime, and they don't understand that it's a crime because in many other areas of business, kickback is legal. An auto car dealership could give business to another one and receive remuneration in return, and it's legal. And people do not understand that, so much so that in the statute itself, Congress decided they're gonna write down specifically that ignorance of the law is not an excuse or a defense. It's never an excuse or a defense, but it's so common in kickback that Congress wrote it in the actual statute.
And, you know, do people actually get sentenced to 10 years for kickback? Is it common that this happens?
I don't want to say common, it happens. It's not unheard of. In South Florida, we're probably number one in the country when it comes to healthcare cases. You will see 10-year sentences in kickback only cases. You will see a lot of hybrid cases where individuals are being charged with healthcare fraud and some counts of kickbacks. And in those, it's even more common to see the 20-year sentences.
And how come kickback has a sentence less than healthcare fraud?
I'm not sure how that came about. Congress wrote the statute like that, but I can tell you that the exposure in sentences is less than a kickback statute than it is on a healthcare fraud.
Well, I think that's the end of it for my questions. Anything else you'd like?
Just a little something. So you, if you're a provider and you're looking at this, these investigations are very common. They've been happening for over many years, decades. They are continuously happening right now. Usually the witnesses against the providers are going to be beneficiaries, because at the end of the day, the money being given ends up, or at least a portion of it, always ends up in the hands of the provider. Provider decides he's going to go to provider A. I mean, beneficiary decides that he's going to go to provider A instead of provider B because he's receiving money. So these are normally going to be the witnesses. Other than that, all that I can tell you, these are all serious offenses. You can look them up and see for yourself. If you're in the healthcare business, folks, stay away from this. It's just dangerous business. You will get arrested sooner or later. I hope this helps. Always feel free to email us at letstalkcrimes@gmail.com. And have a great day. See you next episode. What you gonna do when they come for?